नमस्ते सर.
नमस्ते.
व्हाट आर द लेसन्स कोविड-19 गिविंग अस?
कोविड-19 इज गिविंग लेसन्स टू एवरीबॉडी, टू द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू थिंक व्हाई एवरी ईयर सम काइंड ऑफ न्यू वायरसेस आर अटैकिंग अस, व्हाई इट इज and different manner. Each virus is attacking in different manner. Actually, COVID-19 has affected the entire world, and everybody, it's the best time to realize the power of nature. Actually, I think we the human being, you know, have explored the nature, because of that, you know, it has affected even our air, atmosphere, water, everything. It started attacking the human being.
Exactly, it is mentioned it in our Janavadodamsaniya Vyadi like that. This time our COVID-19, and symptoms are changing and viruses mutating, and world is suffering to find answer. Till Ayurveda community says we have medicines to treat COVID-19. Can you explain why and how?
That is a truth actually. Now here actually Ayurveda community has to think one thing, why that awareness has gone from the society. Years before, especially in South India, in Kerala, our lifestyle was completely, the food habits, dinacharya, everything was, we were following like whatever told in Ayurveda, no? We were practicing it actually. That credit, no, we have to give for our ancestors. The physicians, the vaidyas, no, while patients coming to them, they used to give proper advice on their dinacharya, food habits. Yearly people used to, olden days, no, in Kerala, in our once in 3 months, especially children's, no, parents used to give our castor oil for a purgation. What Ayurveda told, the same thing, no, by in between each Ritu changes, in the Ritu Sandhi, we have to cleanse the system. That type of practice has completely gone from the society. In a way, actually, Ayurvedic people are responsible for that, actually. It was our failure that we couldn't give the awareness to the public. Last century was completely for allopathy. After the British invasion in India, before British invasion, India was surviving only with Ayurveda and Indian system of medicine, Siddha, Ayurveda, whatever, yoga, everything. Now, after the British invasion, lot of the government, no, unfortunately, all importance was given only for the modern medicine. Modern medicine was there in all the countries, and especially in India, we were giving all importance. And that time, actually, Ayurvedic people, I don't know, somehow it had happened, actually. We cannot blame anybody. So what happened, the awareness of our system was reducing day by day. And finally, now in this present period, no, all of us were concentrating only on the patients, those who are coming to us. That also, it became a part of tourism. Then some people started promoting it as for only for wellness. That is not right. Actually, if you think, no, our system, Ayurveda actually, the onset, it was for preventing people from the diseases, actually. That is why in Ayurveda, Swastha Vritta and Adhura Vritta, two parts are there. So if you are able to follow the Swastha Vritta, you are not going to become an Adhura. Eh? That is the main part, actually. somehow we lost. Actually, it is we people have to take the responsibility, because Ayurvedic Vaidyas, as they, we have to teach the people actually. So that part is because of our failure in a way. Even in Kerala and recently, I myself experienced that in some allopathic hospitals, you know, they were keeping a board in front of the gynecology department that a pregnant woman should not take Dhanvantara Guliga. Like that, all negative propaganda, you know, so many negative things against the Ayurveda that they have succeeded. But now people have realized that many medicines are having side effects. There is no proper cure for any disease, only because of the modern technology and other electronics, no? That developments, no? They have utilized maximum in modern medicine. That is why, no, people, no, people are actually general public, they are not aware of everything, but they have a feeling while going to a hospital, oh, they have the emergency care, they have intensive care unit, they have oxygen, everything. Why can't you use it? We can also use it. That is the general science is growing. No? We were failure in that part actually. That is our, even surgery. Surgery was a part of Ayurveda. Sushruta is the father of surgery, everybody has accepted, entire world. Without studying Sushruta Samhita, an Ayurvedic graduate cannot come out, is it not? So why can't you concentrate more on surgical cases? We can use everything, we don't have the license at present. But if you start working on that, we will be able to come out with wonderful results. Even I was going with a surgeon actually out of my interest to know more about the surgery. Unfortunately, I had an accident and I was unable to perform anything actually. Then I have started concentrating on the medicinal part only after that. Before that, I was having an aim like that in my life. So even now we have a lot of, for example, if you take a pregnant lady, in pregnancy, from the day of conception, how the fetus is, the embryo, fetus, each stage of development is very clearly told in our text. And if you observe, no, we can find out everything is truth. In modern medicine, just they are able to supplement some simple things. Why can't we talk to the patients? While a pregnant woman is coming to you, it is your duty to teach them. This is that in that aspect, no, sometimes now everybody was concentrating on maximum number of patients. That is wrong. Even one number of patients, you have to give maximum to that patient. Through that patient, many people are going to come to you. In all Indian shastras, adhidi bodha ajarana prajaranam, is it not? That prajaranam, we have to do it by doing practically, is it not? Then only people will follow that. Even now, I think in Kerala and all, many people have contacted me for taking preventive medicines, how to improve our immunity. That was the success in Kerala. Actually, COVID-19. Kerala, actually, success is many people have taken all Ayurvedic lehams, chavanaprasam, so many things like that. You know, some people were taking kashayam. I was giving to several people. And in Kerala, other part, I mean, even in Kerala, actually, government had taken a very good step. Unfortunately, until now, we couldn't reach to the COVID patient.
Sir, you have told about the Dhanvantara Guliga. It is very, we are we know there is Vaidyayukti is very much important.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, in this COVID-19 case, mm-hmm. how much we can use our Yukti to, some Vaidyas are telling it is preventive aspect,
mm-hmm.
some are curative aspect. Mm-hmm. Both we have some equipments.
Mm-hmm.
How we can do the preventive or a curative? How?
While seeing COVID-19, it is an epidemic. So some medicines can be taken as general. Generally, we can prescribe some medicine in that aspect. But we can do, definitely. I am sure about it. But we have to see the patients. Now we are getting information only through allopathic doctors. Their approach and their investigations are only through the equipments and other tests. And whatever symptoms they are seeing outside, no, that only we know now. We didn't interact with a COVID patient. So while seeing a Vaidya, no, in our eyes, while seeing the patient, first of all, we have to see whether the patient has enough strength, his ojas, his agni, each and every aspect we have to see. Some patients, in my observation, getting a lot of information, in Ayurveda, there are these type of jwara, jwaram, sannipada, we can then, but in many, now the mutation is going on. Actually, we can see the symptoms of that type of jwara. Some are having the symptoms of Raktapitta. Shwasakasam is there. That is there. Even if you observe, only getting information through the newspapers and other this thing. Even Rajayakshma Lakshanam, many, many symptoms are there actually. So while Ayurvedic people, we have to take a patient. Generally, some medicines can be prescribed because it is an epidemic. That we can start from the fumigation, simple, general protocol. But while treating the patient, again, it is going to be individualized. We have to see their agni. We have to see if the patient is getting proper motion. If proper motion is not there, means again, there are chances for epitaxis. No, some patients are showing the symptoms of Raktapitta also.
Sir, could you please explain about that symptom wise, Rajayashma wise, like that? Any?
No, the information about COVID is, I am also getting only through this, whatever is available, coming through the media section. And I am in the part of COVID. So we got some information. But symptoms are seen. Jwara, some are showing Raktapitta, some are showing Shwasakasam is there. And finally, how the death is happening. Mostly, their patients are having some chronic illness like renal, cardiac. But again, if you closely observe it, some areas are like Rajayakshma. And here we may, while getting the patient, even I may change opinion. This is only imagination. While seeing the patient, for us, each patient is different. Some patients' body temperature may vary. Some people may have appetite. Some are not having appetite. We see general medicines as being an epidemic disease. We can select some. But other thing, I think it will be personalized. Then only we will be able to get a good result. With a single drug, I don't think we will be able to get a general public, a group. Again, it may depend upon the age of the patient, the natural strength of the patient. Some people, many people may, but finally, for chronic, those who are having serious attack, we have to give it individually.
Everyone are searching for vaccine, etc. But even they find any vaccine or anything, then also it is only preventive. But already affected so many people. For curative purpose, how we can? It is little bit like Vada, Pitta, Kapha nature. So, what is your?
That no, some cases are like Vada Kapha, some are Pitta Kapha in nature. But where it is, no, it is, I think, how it is becoming very serious, life threatening, no, sometimes. That mostly the patients, they are having some other chronic illness. So, already their body is weak, no resistance. Totally, Vajakshayam is there already. Then this attack is also coming. That I think we will be able to address, no doubt. But I know actually I need to have a consultation with the patient. Actually, that is the truth. Then only the real picture will come out. Sometimes we have to see whether like Raja Yashma, you know, the hair, nail, everything we have to see the patients. For us, no. For us, investigation is darshana sparshana prashna. While dealing, while sitting with the patients, no, you will get the idea from the patient itself how it has affected. And for some people, it will be very easy just by correcting the agni, proper motion, appetite, and give some jarahara drugs, kasahara drugs, they may come out of it. It depends upon the age, basic strength of the patient. I think we have to see the patient. Then only all other things, no, it is going to be a fully imaginary. No?
Modern world is modern science is related with mutation, and in our concepts, there is any chance to become change in desha kala regarding.
Definitely, that is why the mutation means. You were talking about the vaccines. That is also, I don't know actually, olden days, even our forefathers, they have not taken any vaccine. So they could complete their life in a healthy way. Most of them have completed 80, 85, 90, 95 without any disease. People were not depending on the hospitals actually. Now from the olden days, even the birth, childbirth was happening at home. Now everything is shifted to the hospital culture. Is it not? So olden days in Ayurveda, while coming to Ayurveda, no, immediately after childbirth, first we have to give gold, ghee and honey. See, many people are talking against Ayurveda because of mentals. Sometimes, no, even they have to think one thing. No, those who are attacking like that, just see the past 25 years changes in that modern science itself. So see, 25 years before, penicillin was very famous. Why they have stopped using penicillin? Like that, many medicines banning after some years. So in that aspect, even I don't trust the vaccine cells. Have they done any study after giving this vaccine? What are all the changes happening to the particular, especially children's vaccine? I'm totally against that. Actually, it's my personal view. That is why in Ayurveda, we were giving the final extract after mining the earth, you know, the stability. The maximum stability is in the gold, is it not? Which is good for your improving your memory, all nervous functioning, and it is a stability. Actually, we are taking it from the nature. Nature's most stable part, you have to take it after mining, is it not? And we can't give it as it is. We have to purify that. As per Ayurvedic text, we have done it in Coimbatore for a patient. He gave pure 24 karat gold. We have prepared it as per our text. It took more than 9 months for the complete preparation. Now another part, actually, that again Ayurvedic people have to think. While reducing manpower and all other type of everything, now people are taking it as an investment. That is not right. You have to follow the textual way. You have to make the gold thin leaf. Then you have to purify it. As per the text, you know, do it and send it to this labs. I had done it, actually. Everything is in the permissible limit. So the problem is shortcut methods and over-mechanization is creating the problem. In a way, our science is an independent science. Modern medicine or all other science, without having some other help, no? Machine and other help, they are not able to survive. See, our science, no? If no vessels are available, you can make mud pot. Firewood is available. Everything is taken from the nature. Even the metals, gold, purification is only through the available things which is given in the nature. No, nature has given. See, our science is really, you know, it is a totally independent science, actually. We don't want anybody's help. And see the beauty, the fish taking from a coastal region and from a dry land, same species. According to Ayurveda, the properties are different. It is very minute. Why people, even in the animals, human beings, living in Africa, why the change of shape? Living in China, see, we have to see how much Ayurveda is, it's a part of, actually we are also a part of universe, not separating, is it not? So that is why we were having a system that we were giving it immediately after the childbirth to protect the child. From all the, see, if you take the properties of gold in Ayurveda to improve the immunity, to improve the mental strength, to improve all stability, and take the properties of ghee, pure cow's ghee. Pure cow's ghee means, again, it is a human, our no human nature is the problem, greediness, selfishness. Otherwise, a cow, pure cow's ghee. Pure cow's ghee and honey. Honey people are taking very simply. But honey, the bee is sitting in several plants, several flowers. It has got a lot of medicinal value, is it not? Naturally, we are getting it. So maximum taken from the nature to protect the baby. Honey, ghee and gold. First, we used to give for a child, actually. Olden days, that itself is a prevention from the many, the climate, several things are going to affect the child, and people are taking it in a different way. Actually, in according to Ayurveda, we can call a virus as a bhudam. Bhudam means self-generated, swayambhu. Like that, that is why we used to call it as bhudam. Now if you tell bhudam and all, people will think in a different, that's the problem again what has happened for us. No? If you don't know the meaning of a particular word in English, you will see it in the dictionary. Our science is written in Sanskrit. Nowadays, Sanskrit, very, very, very few people are studying Sanskrit. After studying Sanskrit, they will go for some other job. So that is not the fault of the science, actually. If you don't know Sanskrit terms, then you have to find out through the dictionary. Is it not? Some synonyms, you know, for a Sanskrit word, it is difficult to find out in any other language. Equivalent term, is it not? Sometimes we used to use the term of Gridam. Some in some medicines, surface. Why the difference? Surface name given because of the Sarana property. That medicine is acting because of the Sarana property. That is why given the name as surface. Is it not? So some synonyms, it's not the fault of Ayurveda actually.
In this case also, Bodha means already happened.
Already happened.
And Krimi means Kram, Dadu is Kram and Pada Nishpada. Like that, so many derivations are there.
Yeah.
And in COVID-19, there is some Agandu and Purushakara reasons are documented. How comprehensive should the treatment be? How we can tell the comprehensive treatment for this COVID-19?
That is why we have to see the patient personally. It is epidemic, everybody knows, mainly spreading through the droplet.
Sir, even it is imaginary, how we can describe about the possibilities in this?
That is why in Ayurveda, all epidemic diseases, first stage is fumigation. Actually, the fume, the smoke is a minute part. It's a nano, is it not? It's a minute, you cannot hold it, is it not? So, and see the beauty, if you take little chloroform and keep it nearby your nostril, you are going to become unconscious. It is going to the main echo. In Ayurveda, that is our Shiromarmam, Uttamangam. In Shiromarmam, why it has become Uttamangam? Means all, we are getting all the information through, we are able to realize it only through the Panchendriyas. All the Panchendriyas are situated in the Shiras. Is it not? Our basic theory, we have to teach people what is Panchamahabhuta. People are not aware of it actually. So that is why all the Buddhas are represented in face, Shiromarma, is it not? And Nasa is the main rendram, main opening of the to the brain, is it not? That's why the importance of Nasya. So that is why Ayurveda is telling in Dinacharya that everybody has to apply oil on head. Karna Puranam should be done, Nasyam should be done, Gandusham, Netra Anjanam, protecting all the, is it not? So if you are able to follow that, that itself is good for preventing you from many.
Sir, actually you told a very nice example. Likewise, chloroform is for us and this Dubana is for that virus. It is very nice example. And sir, how Dubana, which medicine everyone are using, Aparajita Dhuma. Any other Dhumas we can...
Aparajita, other Dhuma is also there. Actually, some medicines are not available in all the parts. For example, Gulgulu. It's not available everywhere. But everywhere you will be able to get neem. Take simple neem leaves, dry it in sunlight, make a powder out of it. Vacha. Vacha and Kushta, Kottam, and Pathya, Haritaki, Yavam, Mustard, make a powder out of it and add little ghee. Again, if you see the power of ghee, I'll tell you a simple example. Take three lamps, same size. One filled with the coconut oil, another one filled with the gingery oil, another one filled with the ghee, pure ghee, and light it. The coconut oil lamp, you will be able to touch even the flame. Then only you will feel that it is going to burn. Whereas the lamp which is filled with gingerly oil, nearing that, while nearing 1 inch above the flame, you will be able to feel the heat. Go to the ghee lamp. Nearing 3 inches, that heat will be there. That means that through ghee, if it is coming, easy to, the power, the potency of the fire will increase. That is why now you have to mix it with ghee. That is why in olden ancient system, everything, it is not, actually it is not religious actually. According to Ayurveda, we have to see desham, kalam, so many things we have to see. So if everybody, if you are going to high altitude area like Kodaikanal or Ooty, there is no religion. Everyone has to wear some sweaters or something to prevent you from the cold. Is it not? That is called as the samskara of the desha. Whereas there the importance comes actually. Like that, you know, each things having the samskara of this bhumi was yaga yajna. Our concept is actually purva janma kritam papam vyadhi rupena jayate. That shanti, aushadam, japam, homam, mantram, everything is coming there. So homam is also having homam for what? To purify the atmosphere. To purify the atmosphere. It is some herbs, medicines only we are firing with in ghee to increase the potency of the heat. Is it not? To purify the area, big area. For a small, to clean, for a house, no? We can take maximum 20 ml or 10 ml will be enough. If you want to purify a gram, means tons or thousands of liters are used. So that we were using in a nice way with mantra, herbs, medicines. So that was a method of purifying the grama actually.
In this dhupa, you particularly told about this one dhuma. In this ghee and tila also there.
Tila in some cases you can, in this combination, neem, vaja, kushta, pathya, yava and sarsha. With the other medicines, are even tila is also good. According to the availability, this is not a must. If nothing is available, you won't believe. Nowadays, it's difficult to tell actually. In our some ancient books, you know, some part taken from some particular animals are taken for fumigation. Especially this type of this epidemic diseases are spreading. Some parts taken from some particular animals and fumigating it will prevent you. Actually, that is for the purification of your local area actually. So first preference has to go to the fumigation. That is why even in Ayurveda, if you see, if a lady is delivering in that labor room or where the lady is staying, in that room we have to fumigate certain medicines.
Garbhagraha
and prasuti. Different. There lot of these type of organisms, bacteria or virus, or in our language any bhuta can attack. To prevent you from that bodha, this is a must. Even in very bad wounds, ulcerated wounds, you know, like gangrene and that, in some stages, many herbs are taken for fumigation. A deep inflammation in the ear, how will you take it out? Only by fumigating some medicines, you know, keep it near the ear, the pus will come out. Differently, for more than hundreds of dhubas are described in Ayurveda, actually, in different conditions. Hundreds of dhubas are there, actually.
In this epidemic conditions also, we can use dhubas.
Dhubas.
And what about other dhubas then?
First of all, we have to start with dhubas. To purify the air where the patient is living, that air should be purified. Even for prevention, it is good. If you start fumigating it, that area will be out of this virus. Any kind of invisible, so many organisms cannot reach there actually. So first, then after that, if the patient, the rogi is having proper strength, it will be good to give a mild purgation or some mild purificatory technique. In some cases, if the patient is having strength, I think one vamana is going to help them like anything. Simple vamana.
That is, kava is...
All upper respiratory, everything is going to be cleaned. After that, again you have to concentrate on the agni of the patient. Dhadu balam. Dhadu. After correcting everything, finally come to rasayana. Otherwise, no, because of this attack, the patient may get some other problems later. So to prevent the patient from that, we have to give rasayanas, suitable thing.
First, we can go to the preventive aspect. Uh-huh. Then some curative drugs, something like Indugandham, Amardotram, like that.
Indugandham, many things, Vyagra Adi, Bharmi Adi, so many things are there. Dashamula Jiraga Adi, Dashamula Kadatarayam, Bala Jiraga Adi, depending upon the condition of the patient.
We have no scarcity of any drug.
We have everything. There the yukti of the physician has to play.
There is also, we have Bahugunam, Bahukalpam like that.
Bahugunam, Bahukalpam, Sambannam.
We should select. There is, we need to use the yukti of vaidya according to condition.
Yukti of vaidya, and there we have to see the prakriti first. Prakriti of the patient. Balam, kalam. Now in Kerala it is extreme summer. Whereas in some other part of the country it won't be like this. And depending upon the, we have to see the minute parts actually. We cannot come out with a single drug. I don't trust, because our aim is not only to cure the patient. That patient should not face any other problems in the life. That is why, you know, see why Ayurveda has separated the life as three. The first one third is Kapha Pradhanyam, middle part is Pitta Pradhanyam, last Padam. Padam is degeneration. After the age of 55 or 60, that's the age for degeneration, is it not? So, here we have to understand one thing. If a patient, a young boy is affected, means his kapha period, is it not? For the boy, it is kapha period. You have to use more madhu, honey in the tree. Because his period is kapha period. If you don't correct it, his stability is going to be affected permanently. After his period, while he is getting aged, the period is coming for the pitta. If the pitta is improper, what will happen? Already his stability is less. Kapha is got affected with the problems. So, if the pitta period comes, he is going to have to face more problems. If you don't correct that pitta and kapha, what will happen? Finally, the fire will take out all stability. Automatically, the aging is going on. That while he is getting aged, he is going to face lot of neuro or any kind of degenerative diseases. So, if a physician while treating, if you are able to concentrate on that, you will be able to save a patient from many future complaints actually. That is the beauty of Ayurveda. See, everybody's life, you know, the Pitta part is very, 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 very aggressive period. So after the age of 20, 25, up to 50, everyone's life, if you take, you know, they will be busy with the job. Marriage, all problems will come in that period. You know, most aggressive period of the life. If the Pitta, if you are not controlling with proper ghees, so otherwise, either way, you can say if a person is getting a disease in this period, finally you have to correct it with ghee. Otherwise, the patient is going to suffer with in while coming to Vada. So a physician can protect a person from several illnesses. So, see, even if you are not treating Jwara properly, it may lead to Rekta Pitta, is it not? Eh? That is going to Shwasam Kasam, then again Rajarakshma. See, is it not? Eh? Everything is like that. So an Ayurvedic physician can protect a person from several diseases. But you have to spend the time with the patient. You have to hear them. You have to understand their food habits, their lifestyle, everything, and you have to correct it. That now I think we have to start working like that, because people are not having any awareness about the Ayurveda. See, even our last generation, they were not depending hospitals like this. They were having a good lifestyle. So who gave us that these are all the things to be taken as edible? This was not given by any science, no modern science. That was our ancient system. Why we are using more rice? See, people started playing with that actually. For example, I will tell you, 20-25 years before, I am not exactly remembering the year, suddenly people started, especially the modern science group, started attacking coconut oil. What had happened actually? They could sell all bad oils in our place, and now they are telling, especially in US, it is good for heart and brain. So how can you believe that? Whereas Ayurveda, thousands of years experience is there. It has not harmed anybody's health. Even metals also, I was telling you, if you prepare it according to the Ayurvedic directions,
no modern chemistry.
Send it to the lab. Let them find out. Sir. If they don't know, if you don't know to use a particular item, you cannot tell that this is not good. We have reached that much. Is it not? For example, another example I'll tell you. For me, 1.5 years before, I had a food poisoning. Somehow accidentally happened. I was taking male god's urine. I was making medicine out of male god's urine. See, in modern medicine, how many types of urine analysis is there? Are they having a different analysis for a god and human being? Whereas, see, in Ayurvedic text, how can they tell that for this particular condition, you have to take male god's urine? The young generation has to work on that. The Ayurvedic people, we know the difference between cow's urine, human, gods. That is the beauty actually. Even the milk, for them milk is this much fat, this much cholesterol. For us it is not like that. For us, elephant's milk, Hastinya's thyroid. Whereas Mahisha Kshiram, Swapnajana. Or like gods. So see, we have studied everything. They haven't. They have to study that actually. Even now the entire world, you know, India was proud of the Chandrayaan. If you go to take the ancient astrological Sanskrit text, there what is available in Chandra, the moon, everything is written. actually our scientists could do in a different way, that we went to moon, these are all the things available there, but it is mentioned in our ancient book. That means our credibility is increasing, is it not? Like that in Ayurveda, we have to move in that direction, not the present direction. This patrasana, the small kashayam, whether it is effective in arthritis, means we have to see the patient separately. Each person's prakriti is different. Each people are taking different type of food. They are living in different climates. So this one same medicine cannot give the result in all cases. Each person's strength is different. Each person's ojas is different.
Even the COVID is epidemic also. Epidemic
disease. We have to see the Dushan, Desham, Balam, Kalam, Prakriti, everything we have to see. Then only we will be able to give good result. Otherwise, result will be there. Dravyas has to show the action on each disease. It will be limited.
So many researchers are going on Guruji, this Ardra. Like that. Any such medicine, drugs of choice.
All that is good. But one thing is there. So while taking Kashaya Rasa Dravya, it is clearly told by Acharya that in the early stage of fever, if you start with Kashaya Rasa, you will be killing the patient. Is it not? So again, we have to see each person's condition. The physician, we cannot generalize it actually. In Ayurveda, generalizing, no, it is, we will get a result that each dravya has to show that the prabhava and virya or the action will be there. But we may not get the expected result. I think the young generation in Ayurveda, we have lot of works actually. They have to come out of, it's a wonderful science. It was a way of life, especially in Kerala. If you see, I used to think, no, in Kerala, while the Varsha Ritu, see, Karkadaga Masa is coming in that. We were following some particular type of Yusham, Aushadha Kanyi. In that particular month, people used to take such kind of vegetables. That was a system in Kerala. See, like that, from the December, January, you know, it will be little better. Winter, night it will be cold, and daytime it is going to become very hot. People will be affected with several diseases connected with stomachs. See, in Kerala, we used to take Thugakshiri in that particular season. There was a people used to make some kind of edible things, not as a medicine, with Thugakshiri Kuva. Kuva Noru Kondala Kuva Payasam. Aba Tiruvadhara Kakachir. Tiruvadhara Varanda Epudum, January, December, January period.
Between January and
Adem other than while you are coming, seasonal variation. See, this is Grishma. In this season only, we in Kerala, we are celebrating the Vishu. The new year is coming. Why we are using more crackers in this period? Because of Grishma Ritu, even the earth and all the animals, all the herbs, trees, everything is losing their strength because of the extreme heat. So even the diseases can affect the trees, animals, our cows or goat or whatever, dog, whatever you are growing at home. And it will affect the human being also. That is why there, because of the heat, lot of bacteria can affect. That is why people are taking it and always one side only people are seeing. Why we were using crackers in Vishu season? If you see, you know, after the Vishu day, many insects won't be there in that atmosphere, which was causing the problem to the human. So that is also a kind of purification. We were living in such a, well, Kerala life was totally different. and even South India, even North, you know, if you go to the North Indian temples, the prasadam is different, not like Kerala. It is depending upon the climate.
Sir, in this COVID-19, climate have any, so many discussions are going on.
Mm-hmm.
Climate will not be affected by virus, or even though human being...
No, the variation, no, climate will not be affecting the virus, because the nature of virus will be. But in particular climate, the attack, no, some people are getting it in a light way.
Nature of human body is changing.
Definitely the climate is also going to affect. That is why, no, I was telling, no, in Kerala climate is like this. India, in Delhi it is different. In Maharashtra it is different. That difference will be that the attack is also different.
Climate will affect the strength of human body, and it will be indirectly affect the spread of epidemic. There is any chance for that?
Yeah, chances are there actually. Chances are there. Actually, that is not giving the strength to the virus actually. The problem is actually, if it is affecting in this season in Kerala, means it can affect several people. Because of the climate, we lost the strength. So it can affect you harmly. That, again, you know, whatever told in the book, we have to follow fully. You cannot avoid a single word from that.
Any other you have to share? Any other about research or about
research? I, in my view, actually, the present way of research is going to. We have done the. Collaborative study with National Institute of Health, US. No? By God's grace and the Ayurvedic Acharya's blessings, the pilot study, Ayurveda was so successful. But how many are able to believe that? Even now you can see how many negative comments are coming about. Why can't we be propagated? Even we couldn't do that. So, we have to do more researches, but I don't think actually that also the protocol is designed by the allopathic people. Allopathic people's understanding, for example, I told you the difference between urine analysis. How can they understand that? So, they can do it in a different way. While taking Amrit, Guruji, these are all as per today's method, this much information we got. After 10 years, they are going to change the method. Day by day, they are including the scanning machines. Every year, they are coming with the new version and telling this is more accurate than that. Means until yesterday, it was not correct. And tomorrow, they will change it. So you cannot take it as a, is it not?
We have a protocol like Aarum Variyum Neeki, it will not be changed, but
it won't be changed. We have a for everything, even for shundi, ginger, everything we have to see like that. And people, now we have to teach the people our ancient way of living. People were not having this much diseases. Cancer, for example, you take, when I was a kid, you know, once in 2-3 years, we used to hear that particular person is suffering with the cancer. Now, if you ask each family, some of the relative or somebody will be having disease, will be having cancer, is it not? All the diseases are like that. How many people were having Alzheimer's olden days? Now see depression, anxiety, all such kind of diseases are increasing. Why? Why diseases are increasing? We have changed our food style, lifestyle, everything. So we were having, especially in India, we were having a wonderful way of eating habits. the edible things. No, there are a lot of fruits available in the forest. Why we have selected certain things? Why we are giving more importance to wheat or rice? Many juices are, many fruits are there. No? Some are, we are not using the fruits. Why? We were knowing that this is not good. Now it is, the picture has changed. Now if you have some product, you will just project one good property of the product and you will advertise it. That is for short period. That is why still Ayurveda is there. Because of the... Now see, after several years, a new virus came. The entire world, the biggest modern science is stunned. No? They are stuck in front of a virus. Why Ayurvedic people are having this confidence?
We have...
Our system, our fundamentals are based from the universe, Panja Mahabhuta. Even the universe is made by Panchamahabhutam, the human being is made by Panchamahabhutam, the plants, animals, whatever you are seeing in the world is made by Panchamahabhutam. Panchamahabhuta Shariri Samavaya Purusha. So we are actually coming from the minute part to the sukshma to sthula. Whereas modern science is going from sthula to sushma. So that they are going, they are in the way actually. In Ayurveda, I don't think we have to research and find out something new. First of all, we should study whatever told in the book, where it can be applied. That type of studies are going to support Ayurveda in future, I think. We have to change. For that, Ayurveda needs a lot of money, problems are there. Only to convince, no? To convince the people. Today's whatever available methods, this is giving this much. Tomorrow they are coming with a new method. Ayurveda is not going to change. That is why I used to tell, no? 5,000, some people used to tell 3,000-year-old, 5,000-year-old, whatever it may be. If you make Chyavanaprasha, as per the text, you are still getting the same effect. Why modern medicines are changing after 4 or 5 years? Then only they are able to realize, even after doing lot of studies, after starting giving to the patient, after 4 or 5 years only, they are able to understand this, that these are all the side effects affected by the, so banning the product. That's a continuous process there. Whereas here,
no,
we have to start from the beginning, I think.
In this case, in this epidemic, we have to do tell any not to do or patya apatya like that.
Patya apatya. Charya. Actually, the charya, that is why, see the importance of Ayurveda again coming. Whether it is 5,000 or 7,000, according to me, the creator who had created. And one thing people should not forget, actually. I used to feel, whatever you are seeing, no? Whatever you are seeing, you will believe that only. That is the modern world, no? For each and everything, there is a creator. This computer was made by this company. This camera was made by this company. I am the son of this person. And you know, each and everything, this particular table is made by somebody, is it not? The creator is there. Then who is the creator for the universe? Without a creator, nothing is visible in this world, is it not? Eh? You can call it as a supreme power or nature or God, whatever name you can give it, no? So people should realize the power of nature. That is the ultimate truth, is that actually after the creation of universe, who had created, no? In his thought it came that the creatures are going to be affected by wrong food, wrong climate, everything, no? Air, fire, water, everything is going to affect. So how to prevent them from that? So Ayurveda originated only for preventing you from diseases, not only from COVID, not only Ayurveda, here the importance of Vriksha Ayurveda is coming. Here the importance of olden days, people used to travel in horses or elephant. Ashu Ayurveda is there. Hasti Ayurveda is there. Everything was there. That is why an interesting shloka is there. Akalacharyam Mrgayam cha Sahasam. Olden days, no? Very old shloka. Akalacharya, anything, no? Doing it untimely. Mrgayam cha, olden days, no? People used to go for hunting. You know, that type of Sahasam means here, no? It is lockdown, so I can do 3 hours of workout daily means you are doing a sahasam, you are going to spoil your health, is it not? Sudurayanam, no traveling. Now again it is specifically telling Gajavaji Vahana, not only by walking, you should not travel in vehicles also. Nowadays you can tell car, train, aircraft, anything. Grihe Paresham, Anyan Varada, don't go to others' house. Gamanam Chavarthi, Vara, you have to avoid that. Graheshu Rajam Vishamastideshu. Here Graham means Navagraham. Whenever the planetary positions are not suitable, you have to avoid ourselves. In our book itself told, no, Prasangat Gatra Samsparshat. Prasangat, even talking, Gatra Samsparshat. Nishwasat Sahabhojana. Very wonderful, no? Sahasaya Asanaschabi. Don't lie down, don't sit together, is it not? Vastra Malya Anulevana. Don't use other person's clothes. Malyas. Anulevanam. Especially, see, Kushtam Jwarascha Shoshascha Netra Vishyanda. Some kind of skin disease, Jwaram, some fevers. Shosham, again, Rajeshma is coming, is it not? Netra, conjunctivitis is very, very, very commonly seen. No? If a person is having, if he is traveling, everybody is going to get. But like that, some jara, no? Some jaundice, having the spreading nature, very clearly told, no? Thousands of years before. This is called as social, now social distance, no? This is much above than that, is it not? So now I think general public have to come forward what is told in Ayurveda. And it is our duty. Public may not be knowing because of the educational system has changed in India. Now nobody has a chance to know about Indian sciences or Indian arts. And another beauty while talking about India. Our 64 Shastras or all arts. Fundamentals are Panchamahabhuta. Fundamentals are Panchamahabhuta. That is why we used to tell Sarva Akashat Padidam Toyam Sagaram Pradigachati. Sarva Deva Namaskaram Keshavam Pradigachati. Like that, all Indian sciences or arts or whatever it is, finally it is coming to the Panchamahabhuta. That's the beauty of our Bharat actually. No other, I don't think Mahabharata. No other country has an old text in the name of country. We have to, we Indians, no? We should realize the power of India. We should realize the power of, I think for that fundamentally we have to change the educational system. We have to give more importance to Sanskrit. If you study Sanskrit, some kind of culture you will get automatically.
Now we can go to that first question. What are the lessons COVID-19 given us? For an Indian, this is the lesson exactly. Thank you, sir, for your knowledge and sharing this.